This is my strongest year ever. God led me to that decision. Grabe ka, Lord. Grabe ka, 2021. You will never know how strong you are until being strong is your only option.
And if it's not for me, then remove it from my life.
Walang taong may karapatan, ha, na sabihin sa inyo, hindi kayo enough. If this is the waiting time for you, like what it is for me right now, kung may time na parang may isip mo, bakit ka ba gumigising? If you love what you're doing, even if the money isn't there, the money will come. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Filipina Pilot Cheska, and for today's episode, I will walk you through my life the whole 2021. Ano nga ba nangyari sa buhay ko ng 2021? Sometimes we tend to celebrate our big wins, pero nakakalimutan natin to celebrate our small wins. This is a raw vlog. I haven't done any script. Hindi ko man lang inisip ko ano yung gagawin ko or sasabihin ko dito sa vlog na to. Ano nga ba yung nangyari sa akin ng 2021? And sometimes kasi I pressure myself a lot na feeling ko ang dami ko pang hindi na-achieve, ang dami ko pang hindi natapos, ang dami ko pang kailangan gawin sa buhay. And so I want this to be a reminder. In January, I posted a vlog about I lost my job as an airline pilot. And that was a very emotional vlog, also a raw vlog. I just wanna say how thankful I am for that whole year, even though that was the worst year of my life, but also the best year of my life. And this year, I can say that this is my strongest year ever. Sabi nga, you will never know how strong you are until being strong is your only option. And that is so true this year. I didn't have any option but to be strong. Nag-uumpisa pa lang ako, hindi pa ako pwede umiyak. Introduction pa lang yun. Last year, as you all know, I lost my job. And this year, nalaman ko kung ano yung mga kaya ko pa palang gawin outside of my airline life. For the past 10 years, I am working sa airline industry. And this year, turnaround talaga. Content creation career and more of self-discovery. Okay, so January, I am so lucky to have a scholarship with NAS Academy. They gave us a scholarship on how to edit videos and how to script and everything. And so that started again my content creation journey. So last year, I did not make videos. I made videos just for brand collabs, but like videos talaga of educational vlogs. I did not make anything. I'm so thankful with NAS Academy and that scholarship. January also was the time that I knew that I wanted to start my real estate business. I wanted to be a sideline, actually. My friends, they wanted me to sell their property. And I think I will make it full blast na next year. February kasi, that was the time when Cockpit Chatter, Servants, and Sputnik Aviation will have a collaboration sa Airbus A320 simulator. And because I lost my job, I haven't tried anything from March 2020 hanggang Feb. Anything about Airbus. So, wala. Parang hindi ako nakasakay ng simulator, hindi ako nakasakay ng airplane. Wala. So, February was a time that when they invited me to observe yung flight nila sa simulator, parang nagbalik yung feeling of like, oh my gosh, I really want this badly. I really want this back. This is my life. So, February, nag-start kami ng AFP training, ng Air Force Reservist training. So, it's online lang because it's pandemic. So, I was supposed to join last year, but the pandemic happened and so na-move. So, ito yung start din ng online training ko for the Air Force Reservist. For March, I filmed yung video ko na, should you still become a pilot? And it's a video of hope from several. I'm so lucky. I'm really, really lucky to have collaborated with pilots all over the world. and not just here in the Philippines, like Captain Joe, Mentor Pilot, Captain Chris, name it, they're all here. Lahat ng mga idol pilots natin. And they gave me the time to share their words of wisdom to aspiring pilots. And that's my calling. I want people to know that even though it's pandemic, even though you lost your job, even though the aviation industry is down, that we can still get back up again. But I know that this video has helped people to at least have hope kahit pa paano sa aviation career nila. Grabe, sobrang busy ng taon ko. Alam nyo kasi guys, just so you know, gusto ko pinuput into action siya. Oh, this is the time that I also started the my Kumu journey. I can say that for now, it's not really for me. But I really, really enjoyed the time that I started Aviation Tuesdays. I promise. The Aviation Tuesdays kasi, I interview pilots or anybody from the airline industry and ask about their stories so that they too can inspire other people. So I started my Kumu journey, my Aviation Tuesdays during March. And also, yun, ongoing training for the Philippine Air Force. I also have other interviews. Tuloy-tuloy yan, mga school interviews. So April, I joined 1,000 Heartbeats. And it's a game show. First time to join a game show. It's an amazing experience talaga. Like, hindi ko mapapantayan yung kaba and everything. So I got to meet also Cian Lim there and had a collab with him that same month, April. I let him fly the glider. I let people experience this one-of-a-kind adventure. And yun, every month actually, meron akong talk sa mga school as a guest speaker. For May, I had the training sa Air Force, physical training sa Air Force. Lahat talaga nasubukan ko dito. Like, I know how strong physically, mentally, emotionally I am during May because of the training sa Air Force. It was the best and hardest 3 days of my life nung nag-training kami sa bundok. We did the military training talaga. It was intense. It's amazing. It's really an amazing experience and I'm so happy to be part of the Air Force. Skin ko was super sunog and talagang physically tired, drained, but it was worth it. I knew that after that, I can do anything. As in anything. So, akala ko adventurous ako. Alam mo yung pagka-adventurous ko, nawala, guys. Kasi talagang sabi ko parang, I'm enough na sa adventures. I've had too much sa Air Force training ko. I had talks sa school, UST, and yung mga Kumu ko, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung everyday aviation ko. So as in everyday talaga, meron akong ginagawa. There's also an opening for MetaPurse Scholarship wherein 70 lang kayo kukunin all over the world and I think 7,000 yung nag-apply and sent my video to them. For June, natanggap ako sa MetaPurse. It's more of the crypto and NFTs sa NASA Academy. Swerte ko sa mga scholarships. I'm so thankful. August was the time when I passed my Airbus recurrency and my commercial pilot license renewal. So, this was a big month for me. Alam niyo yung feeling na after 1 year and something, nakalipad ulit ako ng Airbus, kahit simulator lang, naipasa ko siya. And I'm good for another 5 years for my commercial pilot license and I'm good for another year for my Airbus recency. Kasi for the past months nga, I fly the small planes and this time around, I got to have the ka-up with me and parang new hope. Pero bang, okay, you're gonna be back real soon. You're gonna be back real soon. So sa akin, malaking bagay talaga sa akin yung August. September naman, na-feature ako sa People Asia Magazine and finisher nila yung life story ko. First time ko malagay sa magazine. Before nalagay na ako sa mga newspaper, yung life story ko. But it is my first time for my life story to be published in an actual magazine. So it's also a big win for me. And this is also the time when Viva Oomph TV contacted me for to be their content creator sa agency nila. Honestly, sobrang laking bagay ng pagdating nila sa buhay ko because I was about to give up on my content creation journey because being a content creator is not easy, guys. I tell you. Mag-iisip ka ng content mo, you're gonna film it, you're gonna be the one to edit it, you're gonna be the one to lahat. It's a one-man show, one-woman show, and it's not easy. And if you think that this gives a lot of money instantly, no. No talaga. So, it's more of a commitment. It's more of a passion. It takes a lot of time. And it takes a lot of sleepless nights. And so, when Viva Oomph TV came, I'm so thankful because, yun nga, parang nag-ignite ulit. God will really give you reasons para mag-ignite ulit yung para sa'yo talaga. Pag para sa'yo talaga siya, ituturi-turi ni Lord yan. Wala kang choice. Parang, girl, dyan ka na. Wala kang choice. God led me to my decisions during September because I know that God led me to it because everything fell into place. Basta September, may nangyaring big event sa buhay ko that I cannot explain or talk about yet. God led me to that decision. And soon, when I am ready, when everything is okay, maybe I can talk about it. But yeah, September, grabe guys, I'm just telling you about my wins. I just want to count my blessings. And I don't want to talk about any negativity right now. October was, it's a soul-searching month for me. Soul-searching month. I went to the beach for business and at the same time for my real estate business and at the same time to find myself and to reevaluate all the things that are happening to me. And because it's too much, guys. Parang ano, it's the month that I told myself that I should love myself more. So, marami namang nangyari ng October. Yung Viva contract signing ko, basta October was like self-love month and soul-searching month. November was my busiest month talaga. Mainly because I said to myself that November, I will work really hard. This is also the month na kinuha ko na OB Montessori for me to share my story to their students and to impart kung ano yung journey na nangyari sa akin kasi I'm also an alumni. Sa sobrang busy ko, like in a day, I collaborate with 3 people to let them fly the plane, yung pilot for a day. I'm so thankful that I get to meet new friends, new people. Alam mo yun, parang nakakalimutan mo din yung mga problema mo at the same time. Although it's work, but I'm really enjoying. And that's what's really important. Alam nyo, sabi sa akin, may nagsabi sa akin na parang, nako, yung YouTube mo, wala naman yan. Kasi, hindi naman ako artista, guys. Wala din akong plano. I know that I'm doing this because it's a passion. Because I wanted my voice to be heard for those people na, alam mo, nawawala na ng pag-asa. And just to inspire them to reach for their dreams. I'm actually enjoying. And so, the whole November, grabe, as in, wala akong pahinga. Tuloy-tuloy every single day. I have collaborations. I have talks. Wala akong day na wala akong ginawa. Kaya palang gawin ng isang month, lahat ng kaya mong gawin ng parang in 3 or 4 months, if you really wanted to. November is also the month na nag-host ako ng Air Force na event. Yung pagsuot ulit ng uniform, tapos na ini-interview mo, mga talagang mga parang yung mga heroes ng mga ano, ng pandemic. December is my birth month. This is also the month na natupad yung isang pangarap ko with the TikTok Philippines na maging ambassador nila as an educational creator almost 2 years ago. Someone told me hurtful words, bad comments, and ridiculed me because I was doing TikTok before, and it wasn't the prime of TikTok yet, but yun nga, I was told that I'm not a TikToker, I'm a professional, I'm a pilot. Anyway, so yung TikTok Philippines, nung kinuha nila ako as an educational creator, I was so, so happy. And it's a dream come true, not just because, of course, TikTok is a brand that I wanted to collaborate with, but more than anything else, it's more of the values that I have. Pagka talaga tama yung ginagawa mo, lalabas yan. TikTok came and I became an educational creator. And for me, it's how I inspire, I motivate, and I educate people. And I'm so happy that I am doing that. And I'm so thankful that I have the power and the platform to do that. Walang taong may karapatan na sabihin sa inyo na hindi kayo enough. All my life, ang dami ko nang narinig na kung ano-ano. And sabi nga, when you are closer to your breakthrough, mas mahirap, mas masakit, mas madami kang pagdadaanan. And I know I'm closer to my breakthrough. Alam nyo guys, sobrang sipag ko. Kung meron man akong pagmamalaki sa sarili ko, masipag ako. And alam ko, when you have a dream at masipag ka, tandaan nyo, dadating ang panahon ng harvest time nyo. If this is the waiting time for you, like for what it is for me right now, dadating yung time na marireap nyo lahat ng rewards nyo. Magtrabaho lang kayo, ituloy-tuloy nyo lang yung ginagawa nyo. If you love what you're doing, even if the money isn't there, the money will come. This is also the time when I went to Davao for another soul-searching adventure because I've had too much. I needed a break. And I'm so thankful that we have a family friend there. And talagang, I went there for a week. I said, kailangan mag-break naman ako. Kasi parang mababaliw na ako sa stress. So, kasi nga, you don't know guys what we are going through. Lahat tayo may pinagdadaanan sa buhay. You know when to take a break. You know when to stop. And yun yung problema sa akin eh. I don't know when to stop. And sabi ko talaga, no, God also gave me this opportunity na, okay, hindi, mag-break ka muna, Chess. You need this. Too much stress already and mababurnout ka talaga pag hindi ka nagpahinga. And so, December was also a soul-searching month for me. And this is also the time that I was able to give back and I'm so thankful. Nangyari yung Typhoon Odette and parang biglaan lang nagpatulong sa akin si ganito, yung friend ko na ganyan, and then nagkataon lang na nakagawa kami ng group to initiate the and coordinate the flight to Siargao, to Cebu, to ganyan, hanggang yung relief operations nagtuloy-tuloy. So I was busy for the past 9 days because of the relief operations. And until now, nagre-relief pa rin kami and tuloy-tuloy pa rin yun hanggang January. And I'm so thankful that I was able to give back. Not monetary man yan, okay lang yun. I get to coordinate with the Air Force, with the Coast Guard, with yung mga private planes, yung mga kaibigan ko sa ganito. And so, yun yung parang naging purpose ko pala. Sabi ko, may time na parang may isip mo, bakit ka ba gumigising? God has a purpose. Sabi nga, if God woke you up this morning, you still have a purpose to fulfill. And I always, always remember that. Because at times, we tend to, oh, sabi ko, hindi ako iiyak, hindi na ako naiyak ng buong vlog eh. Because at times, we tend to forget that we still have a purpose. This may not be the best year, but it made me strong. Marami rin ako natutunan talaga this year. Ang dami kong na-realize. And this is also the year that I surrendered everything to the Lord. Kasi pag hindi mo na kaya, ito na nga rin yung year na parang hindi ko na alam kung ano yung dinadasal ko. As in, pag bago na lang ako matulog, sabihin ko, Lord, I'll surrender everything to you. Kayo na pong bahala. Just lead me to the purpose that you want me to go. Yun lang. And if it's not for me, then remove it from my life. And I think that's it. That's my whole 2021. That's my small wins and my big wins. I'm not ready to share yet my losses. This vlog is really to look back and, girl,
May narating ka naman, may natapos ka naman ng 2021. It's not all about the losses. It's also about the blessings. And I hope you too will find the courage to surrender, to fulfill your purpose, and to just be happy. Natutunan ko ngayon 2021. Importante sa buhay, you're happy, masaya ka, and masaya ka sa ginagawa mo. Kasi ang iksi ng buhay, life is too short to hold grudges. And this year, honestly, I felt so free, so happy. Sobrang daming problems, but I am really, really happy. Na-appreciate ko talaga lahat ng blessings ko, especially my kids. Parang, grabe ka, Lord. Grabe ka. Grabe ka, 2021. Hindi nyo lang alam, pero grabe talaga si 2021 for me. I thought 2020 was na matapang na ako noong 2020. No! 2021 pa pala. And I hope that next year, 2020, I'm very positive about it, that siguro naman, napagdaanan ko na lahat ng kailangan kong pagdaanan and natutunan ko na lahat ng lessons that I need to learn this 2021. And I hope that 2022 will bring good news, na sana kayo rin mahanap nyo yung happiness nyo, mahanap nyo yung blessings and yung purpose ni Lord for you guys. And thank you so much for watching this vlog. If you're here until the end, then thank you so much. And again, this is not about the views. This is more on the people that I will be able to touch. And I hope ma-feel nyo yung kasiyahan and yung peace of mind na para sa inyo. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you like and subscribe, and marami pa ako in store for you for the next year. And next year, medyo mas masipag tayo. Eh. Masipag na nga ako ngayon. Pero next year, that would be my woo! Hope then, I pray for you, guys. I pray for you. And thank you so much for being here, for supporting me, and for those also people who doesn't like me, thank you so much. You're making me stronger every single day. And salamat, because we meet people for a reason. So even if you're a basher, even if you're a supporter, thank you. I love you so much. Thank you so much for watching, guys. And sana gawin nyo din tong ginawa ko para maalala nyo yearly. Para bang photo dump lang to. Ito video dump. Para maalala nyo kung ano na ba yung mga nagawa nyo for the past year. I love you guys. Thank you so much. Happy New Year.